Zero Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hello everyone, my name is Pratap Singh Ramesh More. My group members are Prashant Lohar, Kale Rugwel and Purushottam Jadhav. Here we are presenting our first PBL activity on subject IEQ. Let's have a look on our video.
Title of project: prepare a control chart for attribute data collection in manufacturing industry. Content: introduction, what is control chart, types of control chart limits, 9 steps of QCC, control chart attributes, applications and advantages of control chart, and last conclusion. Introduction: statistical process control was developed as a feedback system that aids in preventing defects rather than allowing defects to occur. One element of a process control system is control chart. Dr. Walter defined the concept of common and special causes during variation during the 1920s at Bell Laboratories. He developed a tool that he called the control chart, which could graphically depict variations. These good charts could also distinguish the two types of variations from each other, thus allowing for the elimination of special causes and the reduction of common cause variation. There are several types of variables data and attributes data control charts. I will be discussing the attribute control chart construction, the attribute control chart, the applications and advantages of this type, and the interpretation of the data. Let's see what is control chart. A graphical mechanism for deciding whether the underlying process has changed based on sample data from the process. Control chart helps determine which causes are special and thus should be investigated for possible corrections. Control charts contain the plotted values of some statistical measures for a series of simple samples or subgroups, along with the upper and lower control limits for the process. Let's see what are the types of control charts. There are two main categories of control chart. First one is attributes data and second one is variables data. First, attributes data. The category of control chart displays that data that results from counting the number of occurrences or items in a single category of similar items or occurrences. This count data may be expressed as pass, fail, yes, no, or presence, absence of a defect. Attributes data are usually represented as non-conforming units and are analyzed by using P, NP, C or U control charts. Variables data. This category of control chart displays values resulting from the measurement of a continuous variable. Example of variable data are elapsed time, temperature, and radiation dose. Variables data are usually represented as X bar and R charts and X bar and S charts. While these two categories encompass a number of different types of control charts. What is control chart limit? Control limits are calculated statistically from your data. They are referred as the lower control chart and the upper control limit on a control chart. These are set at 3 sigma by default since this is the most commonly used limit. Control limit should not be confused with center line. The line of control chart that represent the long run expected on average value of quality characteristics. This is the diagram of control chart limit. The 9 steps in constructing a quality control chart are as follows. First, select the characteristics. Second, develop a quality plan. Third, select the type of control chart. Fourth, choose the proper subgroup size. Fifth, collect the data. Sixth, determine the trial control limit and chart midpoint. 7. Determine the revised control limits and chart midpoint. 8. Construct the revised control chart. And last, 9. Continue to use the chart. This is the decision tree of control chart. Let's see control charts for attributes. Control charts for attributes are used to measure quality characteristics that are counted rather than measured. Attributes are described in nature and entail simple yes or no decisions. For example, this could be the number of non-functioning light bulbs, the proportion of broken eggs in the curtain, the number of rotten apples, the number of scratches on a tile, or the number of complaint issued. Two of the most common types of control charts or attributes are P charts and C charts. Let's see application of control charts. The control chart through originally developed for quality control in manufacturing is applicable to all sorts of respective activities in any kind of organization. They can be used for services as well as products for people, machines, cost, and so on. For example, we can plot errors on engineering drawings, errors on plans and documents, and errors in computer software as C or U charts. Sometimes the quality control engineer has a choice between variables control chart and attributes control charts. Let's see advantages of attribute control chart and conclusion of our project. Advantages of attribute control chart. Allowing for quick summaries. That is, the engineer may simply classify products acceptable or unacceptable based on various quality criteria. Thus, attribute health charts sometimes bypass the need of expensive prices, devices, and time-consuming measurement procedure. More easily understood by managers unfamiliar with quality control procedure. Conclusion of our project. The use of the appropriate control chart will serve to accomplish the objective for which it was invented. The economic control of quality. The economy referred to is the balance of the two mistakes one can make in deciding the fate of a process on the basis of a sample. Either mistake bears with it the risk of tampering to assure that the process is performing in an acceptable manner, done through monitoring the process by inspection. This is example number one. This is example number two. This is our example number three. And this is the end of our project and feedback activity number one. Thank you so much.
Zeal Education Society. Redefining Excellence.